Hi, welcome to my next video. This time something a bit unusual because it's another DIY project. I have posted on my social media recently that I made a custom keyboard to be used with Procreate shortcuts. And a lot of you have asked me about how to make it and why would you need one. So I wanted to make a quick video to show how I make a version number 2 and also explain how you make one and why would you need a custom keyboard for Procreate shortcuts. And I personally think that if you are painting a lot in Procreate, you could benefit a lot from having a custom made keyboard. And this is because if you have a USB or Bluetooth keyboard, just a regular one, connected to your iPad and you are using it for Procreate shortcuts, the shortcuts are not ergonomic because they resemble the shortcuts from Photoshop. So you have E for eraser, B for brush and space and Command Z for undo, but also you have the bracket keys for brush sizes, for example, which are on the other side of the keyboard. And you have to move your hand and use 2 or 3 keys shortcuts for undo, redo. It's not ergonomic and it takes a bit of time to get used to it. So maybe even if you try to use the shortcuts for Procreate, you'll be like, it's better to just click this on the screen. But a custom keyboard allows you to do something that you cannot do on iPad right now, at least I don't think you can. So you can customize the placement of all your shortcuts, and also you can make, for example, Shift Command Z, which is redo, work by pressing just one key. So you can make simple macros also. And this is all possible because you program your custom keyboard with your custom firmware that has your settings in it and your macros and your key placement, etc. So the keyboard works as you wish it to. This is a bit difficult, but there are a lot of tutorials on YouTube and articles on the internet explaining how to make a keyboard, where to order the parts from, and how to program it. So if you have any experience in making DIY stuff and any experience in soldering, for example, making a simple keyboard is actually really simple. So in this video, I'll be making the simplest keyboard probably possible, and I'll be showing you how I did this. Okay, so you need the parts. The first is the PCB, so the base of your keyboard, and also it will connect all the parts together. There are a lot of sizes and shapes with different key placements, but I'm choosing here the simplest one only for my left hand that also has the place for the controller, and this is a simple 25 key layout. Okay, other than that, you need the switches, so the buttons that actually make the keyboard work. And these come in many variations, ones that click, make the clicking sound, or are harder to press and are lighter to press, and so on and so on. But there are 2 main types that you have to choose from. High ones like these that make a keyboard, like a traditional mechanical gaming keyboard, a bit high, thick, and also low profile ones like these that make for a thinner keyboard. And because I want to just put the keyboard on my desk and use it for a long time without tiring my wrist, I will go for the lower ones today. Okay, you also need the keycaps, which are the plastic parts that cover your switches and make it easier to press them. And they also come in many colors and shapes and designs, and you have to choose your own. I'm going here for really simple black ones without any letters, without any prints on them, because I want to program my buttons by myself and this keyboard will not be used for writing, so just for shortcuts. You also need simple diodes, one for each button, and these just make the circuitry work, and a controller chip that allows you to connect the keyboard to your computer. A simple controller will come with a USB micro, so you just connect it with a USB cable to your computer, but also you can buy a bit more expensive ones with USB-C or even Bluetooth connectivity. And I have here one that has USB-C and Bluetooth. In the future, I want to make this keyboard wireless. To make this keyboard stand a bit better on the desk, I will just use rubber feet kind of thing that I will stick on the bottom of the PCB. But you can of course buy cases and back plates and middle plates and all kinds of backlight effects and LED panels and whatever to make your keyboard even more awesome. But here I'm going for the most simple design I can think of. So, okay, making this keyboard is really simple. The first step is to put in the diodes in the right direction. The places are marked on the PCB with the diode mark, and it also tells you the direction you have to put the diodes in. On each diode you have a black belt and it has to match the line on the PCB mark. So I just put all the diodes in, solder them in place and cut the excess legs. The next step is to put in all the buttons. They go in only one way, so I just put all of them in and solder them in place too. The last step, this is only a three-step process really, is putting in the controller, and I'm using here a quick connection socket that allows me to swap the controller, and I want to do it because later I will use a USB-C, the wireless one. So for now I'm just putting a regular Arduino Pro Micro with the quick socket to check if the keyboard works. So I just put it in, connect it to my computer and program it with the software needed for my keyboard layout. If you are using a ready-made circuit board, your keyboard is probably a standard kind of a keyboard, so you can use an online configurator app to program it. You just put your keys where you want them, just drag and drop, and you can download a firmware file to program your keyboard. You connect it to your computer, program it, and your keyboard is practically done. You can just put it later into a case, or in my case, I'm just putting some rubber feet on the bottom of it. Okay, so this is my layout that I use for painting in Procreate. It has the brush, the eraser, and the brush size controls really close to each other, so I can just have my hand always on these buttons. I also have the Alt on my thumb for the color picker and some other useful shortcuts really close to each other. And this is how it works in Procreate. I bought all the parts for this keyboard in my local custom keyboard shop. We have one in Tokyo, but you can also buy the parts online. Just remember, if you are buying from not a local shop, they will probably take a long time to get to you. Also, the cost of this was about $40, I think, for all the switches, keycaps, and all the parts here. But this is also because I made only the left part of the keyboard, so I didn't have to buy so many buttons and keycaps and so on. If you want to make your own, just Google. I learned from YouTube about this, and there are a lot of really good tutorials all over the internet and really good and vibrant communities that make their own keyboards. Okay, if you have any questions about custom keyboards, please don't ask them, because I'm not really an authority about that, and there are a lot of more knowledgeable people on YouTube about this, so just search for them. I hope you like this video. As always, feel free to comment, share, and subscribe, and you can also support me on Patreon. See you in the next one. Bye.